Hello and welcome to this video on the engineer schedule. By now you should know how to fill out a job sheet. If you are not sure, please refer to the video linked below. In this video, we are going to go through how to set up a contact as an engineer, assigning jobs to an engineer, applying colours to jobs, and tips and tricks of the engineer schedule. The engineer schedule is a feature on Clik Service used to schedule and monitor jobs. To do this, we are going to go to the diary at the top and then hit on this tab that says engineer schedule. In here, we will see all of our engineers listed. If you do not see any engineers, we will need to set our engineers up. To do this, go to settings and then staff. Once we are in here, we need to set the engineer up as a staff member. We already have a how-to guide on how to do this if you're not sure, so pause it here and come back when you have them set up. When they are set up, we can highlight on the person we want to add to the schedule and tick engineer. We can then add them to a department and change their schedule colour. If you want to have a subcontractor engineer show on the engineer schedule, then create the subcontractor company in CRM. Then go to Contacts and then create the engineer. At the bottom, tick the engineer box. They will now show on the engineer schedule. Now we need to assign jobs to the engineer. To do this, go to the job that you want to assign and go to the Engineers tab. Once you are here, click on Add. This will bring up a miniature version of our engineer's schedule. You can either highlight the date and the engineer on the schedule, or you can select the engineer from the drop-down at the top and fill in the date and time. When you are happy, click OK to add it into the schedule. This job is now assigned to the engineer. If your engineer uses Clik Remote, they will now be able to see the job. If the engineer uses Clik Jobs, you will need to click Sync Job before they can view it. Please note, the responsible user on the job details page is not the engineer. It is the person in office that takes charge of the job. There is a setting that changes the status of the job once the engineer has been assigned. For example, my default status is unassigned. When I assign an engineer, this will automatically change the status to assigned. To do this, go to Settings, Modules, and then Job Sheets. In here, you can set your default status at the top. And then tick on Engineer Assignment, Set Job Status To, and choose your status. Now when I create a job, the status will be unassigned by default, and when I assign the engineer, this will automatically change the status to assigned. When you are in the engineer schedule, you will see there is an overview column at the top of the list of engineers. This is going to show all unassigned jobs. You can either click into the job from here and assign the engineer like we did before, or you can drag and drop the job to the engineer you want to assign. However, if we do drag and drop the job, this will then assign them for the time that was entered in the start and end time. You can drag and drop the jobs from one engineer to another. When you do this, it will come up with two options. If you create new entry, this will add the new engineer as well as the original engineer to the job. However, if you choose move entry, this will move from the first engineer to the new one. In the engineer schedule, you can see the jobs are different colours. These colours can come from a few different places, depending on what you have set up. You can set up colours for statuses, fault codes, and categories. To do this, go to Settings, Modules, and then Job Sheets. Scroll to the bottom and click Setup Colours. Go through and set colours for each. To get these colours to show on the engineer schedule, in the settings, go to Schedule. Then tick Enable Job Colours and choose whether you want the status, fault code or category colours to show on the engineer schedule. I'm going to choose status. Now when you go to the engineer schedule, you will be able to see what status the job is in from the colour of the job. If you want to pop out the engineer schedule, click on this pop-out icon on the top right. This will allow you to put it onto another screen and carry on using Clik like normal. If you only wanted to see the schedule for a certain department, on the right hand side, choose what one you want to see from the dropdown. You can also choose who you want to see by ticking or unticking the engineer you want to show. If you click Invert, this will swap the ticked and the unticked. If you want to tick all engineers, click Select All. You can also see who doesn't have any jobs assigned for this week by clicking on Free Engineers. At the top, you can choose what you want to see in the schedule. For example, you would most likely want to see the holiday so you can see if your engineer is off that day. Next to that, we have the different ways you can view the schedule. You can go for month, week, day, or workday. Then choose the start date that you want to see. On the bar below, we have the option to print the schedule. Fit appointments will push the bars up to fit as much onto the page as possible. And then restore view will open it back up to how it was before. If you tick Show Tooltip and hover on top of the job, it will show some details of the job without having to open it up. Inline job editing will allow you to edit parts of the job without opening it. And then you have Auto Refresh, which refreshes the engineer schedule every so often. Below that, you have the option to hide completed jobs, assigned jobs, invoice jobs or completed contract visits. However, this will only hide for the overview column. Thank you for listening.